most of the non-Muslims, including many so-called Muslim scholars, inverted commas, they translate jihad as the holy war. Holy war, if you translate in Arabic, it means harbu muqaddasa. If you read the Quran, if you read the Hadith, there is no Quranic verse, there is no Hadith which uses the word harbu muqaddasa. The word holy war doesn't exist in the Quran, neither in the Hadith. Jihad, as I mentioned, basically means to strive and struggle. And one type of jihad is also fighting in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is qital in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But jihad doesn't basically mean a war. One type of jihad, there are various jihad for nafs, one type of jihad is fighting in self-defense in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we see the history of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first 13 years of his prophethood that he lived in Makkah, there were many Quranic verses that were revealed, all the Makkan surahs. Many a time in these verses, the word jihad was used. And never did the Muslims ever fight, physically fight. Only when they migrated to Medina, then the wars took place. But yet you find the word jihad in several verses of the Quran which were revealed in Makkah. Many examples I can give you. For example, Quran says in Surah An-Kabut, chapter number 29, verse number 69, that those who do jihad in the way of Allah, those who strive in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we open up the pathways for them. When the verse was revealed, there was no war at that time. Quran says in Surah Furqan, chapter number 25, verse number 52, that do not follow the unbelievers, but do jihad against them. Strive against them strenuously with the Quran. That means you do jihad with the Quran. Jihad with the Quran means strive to convey the message of Allah. Do you think you're going to fight with the Quran? So here we realize that this misconception regarding the word jihad, it is depending how the media portrays. This word jihad wasn't a problem a couple of decades earlier. After 9/11, it came on top of the charts, number one. Previously, it wasn't there. So depending how the media portrays Islam, these misconceptions arise in the minds of the non-Muslims. For more details on jihad, you can see my lecture, my talk, Terrorism and Jihad, an Islamic Perspective.